each other, and I won't leave you. Always be true. 1 + 1, 2 for life. Over and over again. Over and over again. From the way you smile to the way you look, you capture me unlike no other. From the first hello, yeah, that's all it took. And suddenly we had each other, and I won't leave you. Always be true. 1 + 1, 2 for life. Over and over again. Need more. Now I found the one to live for. No one else will do. And I'm telling you, just put your heart in my hands. I promise it won't get broken. We'll never forget this moment. It will stay brand new because I love you over and over again. From the heat of night to the break of day, I'll keep you safe and hold you forever. And the sparks will fly, they will never fade, 'cause every day it's better and better. And I won't leave you. Always be true. 1 + 1, 2 for life. Over and over again. So don't ever think I need more. Now I found the one to live for. No one else will do. And I'm telling you, just put your heart in my hands. I promise it won't get broken. You'll never forget this moment. It will stay brand new because I love you over and over again. So don't ever think I need more. I got the one to live for. No one else will do. And I'm telling you, just put your heart in my hands. I promise it won't get broken. We'll never forget this moment. And we'll stay brand new because I love you over and over again. just how blessed I feel. I know, as all those years ago, your mom handed you to me.
Well, good afternoon to all of you, family and friends. Thank you for being here. I know Austin and Kristen want to thank you for all being here on this day when they're going to make a lifelong commitment to love and care for each other the rest of their lives. And today they'll stand before you and before God and make this lifelong promise that they will love each other as long as they live. And I remember 15 years ago, I showed up to a cabin in Big Bear, California, and I met Austin for the very first time, this teenage punk. And I was just some random guy who happened to be dating his sister. And since then, I've watched him grow into the man he is today, which I can say as his soon-to-be brother, well, and brother already, I'm proud of. Not just any man, but a man of God. And I've also gotten to know Kristen. We haven't known each other as long, but there is one thing that is evidently clear, and that is that today, Austin is totally marrying up.
I was like really serious there for a second.
So, it goes without saying that it is an honor and a privilege to officiate this wedding today. You all may be seated. You know, I was trying to think of something I want to say to the two of you, and I came to the conclusion that I want to say something that some may deem controversial, okay? But whatever, I have the mic right now, so I'm just going to say whatever I want, okay? So here it is, and this is a true statement. The love that you have for each other is not enough for you. It's not enough for your marriage. And I just want to make sure you've heard that. The love that you have, it's not enough. Now, before someone charges the front and attacks me for saying something like that, let me just clarify what I mean. 13 years ago, I married your sister, my then fiance, who's been my wife now for 13 years. And my response to many people who would say to me, "Why are you marrying her?" was, "Well, I love her." And that was true. I do love her. I loved her then, I love her now. I loved how gifted she was, how smart she was, how funny she was, how beautiful she was. I truly did love her. But 13 years later, I've come to the realization that that love was never enough. It was never enough. Still, if you don't believe me, you could ask many of the people over the last year, a million couples who've decided, you know what, this marriage needs to end. You could ask them, before you got married, did you love each other? And they would say, well, of course we did. Of course we did. So I want to let you in on a little secret today. And I think that this is the secret to a healthy, dynamic, vibrant marriage, okay? Because here's the truth. I don't really care what happens the rest of the day. I don't. I don't care what napkins you have or what party gifts there's going to be. I don't really care what food you serve. Well, that's a lie. I do care what kind of food you serve. But here's what I care about the most. I don't really care about what happens the rest of this day. I care about what happens the rest of your lives. And so here's the secret. And I wish I could say I came up with this, but I'm certainly not smart enough to come up with a secret like this. And it would be lying of me if I said I did. In fact, this was God's idea. When he set all this up, this relationship, love, marriage thing, he came up with this one thing that I think is the secret to having that healthy, vibrant marriage. And it comes from Proverbs 11:30. And he says this, "The seeds of good deeds become a tree." You see, most of the time we think of weddings and marriage, and we think only of love. The emotions and the feelings and this passion that exists inside of us. And those are great things. But when I think of marriage, when I think of weddings, and when God thinks of marriage, he thinks of serving. Every Sunday, Kristen, my wife, does something that you would call a seed of good deeds. Okay? And you won't find this thing that she does in any marriage book. Right? If you went through premarital counseling, we didn't talk about this. You would never talk about it in marital counseling. But this seed of good deeds is something that helps our marriage be as healthy and vibrant as it is. It's a small thing, but man, it's a great thing. You want to know what she does? She cleans our bed sheets. There are fewer things I love more in this world than fresh sheets. The only thing above that are new socks.
Yeah.
And I can't explain it, but when I slip into bed at night, on a Sunday night with fresh sheets, I am shown how much my wife loves me. It's a seed of good deed that is helping our marriage to become this strong tree. On the flip side, I've learned to do the same. For instance, my wife hates, and I mean hates, to clean the entire kitchen. It does not happen. She'll do some of it, she'll do a little of it, but rarely will she do all of it. And I'm not sure what happens between her deciding to start cleaning the kitchen and slipping out of the kitchen halfway through and finishing. But there's something that happens. And at first I would sort of rant, like, why would you do that? Why would you start something and not finish it? And why do I have to come up behind you and always clean this up? But over time I've learned, you know what, this is a way I can serve her. This is a way for me to plant that seed of good deeds. And so now when she leaves, when she's decided enough is enough, I'm able to come up behind her and finish what she started. I also picked the chicken off the bone because she doesn't like to eat chicken off the bone, if you didn't know that. Yeah. The Apostle Paul's first words about marriage in the book of Ephesians, the very first words he says are this. It doesn't say, learn to love each other. It says, submit to one another. Granted, the act of submitting to another person is a little unnatural, right? In fact, it makes us a little bit queasy sometimes when we think about that, because we're selfish people, right? And we'd much rather be served than serve, right? In fact, marriage will push your selfishness to the very edge. And when it gets there, my greatest hope is that it just falls off. It falls off, because if you do, you'll discover the benefits of understanding love really isn't enough for your marriage. You'll discover that true intimacy in a marriage isn't accomplished by simply saying you love each other or experiencing those emotions that you might have, but showing it by planting seeds of good deeds every single day. Now, earlier I said I wish I'd come up with this idea, which I did not. But the secret was God's idea long before it was ours. And here's the most beautiful thing about God. He didn't just talk about this. He demonstrated it. Romans chapter 5, verse 8 says that God demonstrates his love for us in this, that while we were still sinners, selfish people, Christ died for us. In other words, God didn't just say, I love you, and walked away. He decided to serve us despite our selfishness. There's this great story in Mark chapter 10 where Jesus' first followers are debating and they're having these conversations, and two of them, very bold, walk up to Jesus and they say to him, I want you to do whatever I say you should do. And that's a bold statement when you're talking to the Son of God. And Jesus goes on a bit of a rant, and then he says this. He says, whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant. The seeds of good deeds become a tree. And I want your marriage to be a forest of beautiful trees that you have decided every day when you wake up, I'm going to plant seeds of good deeds in my marriage. I'm going to serve the other person, because if you do, you will discover the beauty of that secret that God has not withheld from us, but has given to us clearly. In a minute, you're going to make promises to each other that will serve as a foundation on which your marriage will be built. But in the end, they're just words. Make them more than that. Put them to good use. Make them your life's pursuit to serve each other in the same way that Jesus has served us. Let me pray. God, we thank you first and foremost for Jesus, who came and became one of us, who lived a humble life and did what we couldn't do for ourselves and died a death that we deserve, but did it because you love us so much. I pray that all of us here would learn from that, especially Austin and Kristen, as they come together in this marriage, that they would see the importance of every day planting good seeds of good deeds, that their marriage would flourish. God, we thank you for the love that they have for one another. But God, I just pray that whatever is said here today, the things that are said here today would not stay here, but that they would go with them. They would act upon them each and every day. In your name we pray. Amen. Well, I have said my piece, so now it's about to get real. All right? So, Austin, will you have Kristen to be your wife, and will you love her faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will.
I will.
And Kristen, will you have Austin to be your husband? And will you love him faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will.
I will.
Austin and Kristen have decided to read each other just a small note, and so.
All right, wish me luck here. Kristen, I never believed in love at first sight until I met you. As soon as I saw your smile and felt the genuine kindness that you radiate, it was game on for me. In the weeks that followed, I fell in love with you more and more. I love your innocence, your ability to empathize with everybody at any time. I love the way you make the whole world feel loved and the passion behind your eyes. Believe it or not, I even love the way you talk excessively to complete strangers. Because the truth is, if it wasn't for you, I probably wouldn't make new friends. I knew early on that I would never meet anyone who could support me and love me the way you do. I believe with all my heart that God placed you in my life at the perfect time for the perfect reason. Thank you for believing in me. For pushing me to be a better man. For being the light that guided me out of the dark. And for holding me up when I couldn't stand on my own. I'm so excited to see where this life is going to take us. And with God and you by my side, I'm ready to lead our family.
You hate this, and I'm doing it anyway, so that's okay.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, well, I should have gone first. My love, we made it. Through this year of craziness, through the last 3 years of growing up and growing together. How I understand the meaning of partnership because of everything we have made it through. We're good. Thank you for allowing me to be me and talk so much and truly be comfortable expressing emotions I typically don't. Your patience, kindness, determination, passion, and humor are all reasons I'm standing here today. It's amazing how well we complement each other, a street smart, book smart-ish blend of awesome. I'm so grateful for the way you stepped up, really taking hold of this adulting thing. And I love where our lives are going. I am so excited to represent the Carstens name for both past and future generations, creating a family and a home we're super proud of. I love you with everything that I am. Spring rolls, honey. Let's do this.
Okay. Austin and Kristen, since it's your intention to share with each other your laughter and your tears and all the years will bring, by your promises, bind yourselves to each other as husband and wife. Austin, if you'll repeat after me. I, Austin, take you, Kristen.
I, Austin, take you, Kristen.
To be my wife from this day forward.
To be my wife from this day forward.
To join with you.
To join with you.
And share all that is to come.
And share all that is to come.
With God's help.
With God's help.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
To respect, trust, and care for you.
To respect, trust, and care for you.
To always be honest with you.
To always be honest with you.
To stand by your side.
To stand by your side.
Through the peaks and valleys of our lives.
Through the peaks and valleys of our lives.
Always seeking God's direction and counsel.
Always seeking God's direction and counsel.
As He guides our life together.
As He guides our life together.
Kristen, if you'd repeat after me. I, Kristen, take you, Austin.
I, Kristen, take you, Austin.
To be my husband from this day forward.
To be my husband from this day forward.
To join with you.
To join with you.
And share all that is to come.
And share all that is to come.
With God's help.
With God's help.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
To respect, trust, and care for you.
To respect,
trust and care for you.
To always be honest with you.
To always be honest with you.
To stand by your side.
To stand by your side.
Through the peaks and valleys of our lives.
Through the peaks and valleys of our lives.
Always seeking God's direction and counsel.
Always seeking God's direction and counsel.
As he guides our life together.
As he guides our life together.
Get out the rings, please. These rings are a symbol of your commitment to each other. They serve as a reminder of the promises you've made to one another today. So Austin, if you would. And Austin, as you place Kristen's ring on her finger, please repeat after me. Kristen, I love you.
Kristen, I love you.
And I give you this ring.
And I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
And Kristen. And Kristen, as you place Austin's ring on his finger, repeat after me. Austin, I love you.
Austin, I love you.
And I give you this ring.
And I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness. If I can get it on. You want to help?
So may you put into action that which you've promised today. Don't let your marriage vows stay here. Take them with you. May they always be present in your marriage. And may your ring be a constant reminder of that love and affection and commitment you have for one another.
Well, hey, I'm the one who doesn't like to clean the kitchen. Hi, busted. So in a moment, Kristen and Austin are going to do something that's not very traditional in a wedding ceremony, but is something that's transformational in a marriage. They're going to wash each other's feet. Ryan mentioned that he hopes that Austin and Kristen make it their life's pursuit to serve one another as Jesus served. And one of the things Jesus did when he was here is he washed his disciples' feet. He was God, and he served people in such a simple, profound way. And Kristen and Austin want to do that for each other. In John 13, it says, "Having loved his dear companions, Jesus continued to love them right to the end. It was supper time. Jesus knew that the Father had put him in complete charge of everything, that he came from God and was on his way back to God. So he got up from the supper table. He set aside his robe and he put on an apron. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the feet of his disciples, drying them with his apron." And they didn't like this. They were, one guy in particular, Peter, was like, "You can't do this. Like, you're Jesus." And he's like, no, I can. I can. Because I came here not to be served, but to serve. And I want to show you how to do this, because this is how you're going to live best in relationship with other people. To set aside your robes, to pick up your aprons, and to do things for other people. So later he said, "Do you understand what I have done to you? You address me as teacher and master, and rightly so. That is what I am. So if I, the master and teacher, washed your feet, you must now wash each other's feet. I've laid down a pattern for you. What I've done, you do. I am only pointing out the obvious. If you understand what I'm telling you, then act like it and live a blessed life." And so today, this afternoon, as you wash each other's feet, and for the rest of your life, as you serve each other, I want you to know that the vows you just said are only as strong as your willingness to live them. And it's difficult and it's hard, but it's so worth it. And so as you're over there doing this, I want you to know that by serving each other, by dying to your own desires, by daily choosing to set aside your robe and to sacrifice for each other, forever is possible, and it's beautiful like few other things can be. So go for it.
I once was lost, but now I'm found. I once was lost, but now I'm found. So far away, but I'm home now. I once was lost, but now I'm found. And now my life song sings. I once was blind, but now I see. I once was blind, but now I see. I don't know how I see, and now my life song sings, and now my life song sings, and now my life song sings. I once was dead.
God, to think that you would leave your place in heaven and come to earth to get down on your knees like Kristen and Austin just did and wash the feet of your disciples is just humbling to even think about. And seeing that picture, God, that's true love at its finest. Two people willing to lay down their pride and their selfishness and all that they hold dearly to give and to serve for the other person. I pray that that is what marks Austin and Kristen's marriage from this day forward. In your name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, before God and in the presence of this congregation, Austin and Kristen have made their solemn vows to each other. They've confirmed their promises by the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, by the authority given to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I proclaim that they're now husband and wife. And as the scriptures say, a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united into one. Austin, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Austin and Kristen Carstens. Let's go. If you wouldn't mind, and if you're able, grabbing your chair or two, we need those to head back up to the building to be set up for the reception here in just a minute. Thank you.
Strong and our hearts are kind. Let it take.